Hello and welcome to this tutorial where we're going to take a look at the cross-section module that was added to Kubla Cubed 2019 XS edition, which is version 5.9 of the software. So if you've got Kubla Cubed 2019, make sure that your version number reads at least version 5.9. And then you should find in the measurement panel that there is a new cross-section option. The first thing to mention is that cross-sections are, like the other measurement tools, unique to the phase. So when you draw a cross-section, it will record the information on that phase only. It doesn't collate information through the phases. So to start, we'll just create two cross-sections. So you click on the cross-section and then left-click, and then when you're ready to finish the cross-section, you right-click. And then I'm going to create another, what's sometimes known as a long section, along the center of a path, just to demonstrate that you can create sections with more than one point. So you've got two sections here. So you will notice that there is a reverse viewing direction option. So every section has a viewing direction. When the graph is produced, it's the direction in which you're looking. If you can imagine looking at as a slice through the terrain, it's which side you'll be standing on. So it's indicated by these arrows here. So when you just change that, it will change the viewing direction. So that's really the only option that you have in the section, apart from the ability to view it. So we'll view this section here. So this is the graph that you can access from within Kubla Cubed. And it's useful for sort of validating your data and understanding your earthworks. It has existing is a pink line, proposed surface is indicated in green. You can zoom in and out with the middle mouse scroll wheel to get more detail. You'll notice if you put the mouse on any point in the graph, you can view the proposed level, the existing level, the fill or cut value, and also the distance from the beginning of the section. So that's all quite useful. There is also an indicator of what the exaggeration is being used. So in this case, it's 2. You can change the exaggeration by just changing the exaggeration of the phase. So this is exaggerated by 2. If I turn it off completely, when I go into view the section, it's now vertical exaggeration 1, which is no vertical exaggeration. Okay, so that's the a look at the cross-section viewer within the program itself, but often you want to export sections for the purposes of sending to clients and including in reports. So to do that, there's quite a number of options actually, and we'll start by looking at the create drawing option. So if you create a drawing, either a PDF or CAD one, you'll find that the sections are included in that drawing. So we'll just demonstrate that by exporting a PDF drawing. You've got all the standard drawing options here, so you can include the triangulations, you can generate contour lines if you like. And now when we click OK and save the file, we should find that the sections that we've created are marked on the proposed, that phase. So we've got them marked here, here, section 1 and section 2. And in addition to that, you should find also the graphs included in the report. This is a great way to increase understanding of your project. If you draw sections over key areas, then stakeholders can look at the graphs and understand what's happening a lot better. That's just as true for CAD. You just follow the same process. You go create drawing, CAD file, and then the sections will be included in their own layer. So another thing that is useful when it comes to exports is the ability to export all the cross-section data for use in generating your own graphs. File, create, create spreadsheet, and then cross-sections, and here you will get a spreadsheet breakdown with all the data you need for producing graphs in third-party software, like for instance Microsoft Excel. The advantages of this is that you can combine them with other data sources, and you can even combine different cross-section outputs together. So in Kubla Cubed and the drawing exports, you only will view the existing and proposed. However, you might want to combine cross-sections in different phases together in a single graph. Now to do that, you can take the approach of exporting to a spreadsheet and combining them in Excel and then creating your own graph. So I'll just demonstrate that quickly. I'm going to delete this the long section from here, so it's simpler. And then I'm going to copy this section into the strip phase So I'm going to just do edit copy and then go into my site strip phase and edit paste. And then I'm going to create a spreadsheet of the cross sections. And then we're going to take them into Excel. So there's a site strip thing and there's a bulk earthworks one. And I'd take those into Excel and demonstrate how to combine them together. So go save. So it wouldn't necessarily be just for the strip that you might want to do this. It might be if you've got a backfill project and you want to examine the existing, the excavation, and then the backfill in different, in the same graph. So we got the site strip information here. And then we've got the bulk earthworks information on this one. And so the bulk earthworks one has got this section, and it's got, in this case, what we are actually interested in is the existing levels, because the existing levels of the next phase will actually be the strip level. So I'll just demonstrate by doing it. So I'm going to copy and paste these existing levels, which are basically the original ground levels. Now, I don't want them to be in the existing levels. I want them to be in their own column. So I copy and paste that. So I've got original ground. Ground. Meters. As the existing of the bulk earthworks is actually the result of the strip. So I've got the proposed level of the bulk earthworks, the strip, which is a rename from existing, and then the original ground. Now, when I take these three columns, four columns, and I go insert, and it's important to select scatter graph, which is the one you want, either the one with straight lines or markers, or just the one with straight lines on its own. And you'll see. It creates a graph with three different surfaces marked. So I've got the original ground level, the strip, which is just reduced by a meter, as you can see, and then the proposed. So it's a bit fiddly, but when you get your head around it, you can combine the different surfaces from different phases, which is something that you can't do with the standard tools in Kubla Cubed. So that's it for cross sections. As usual, if you've got any questions, please post in the comments or on our forums. Thanks for watching.